left the hospital when Marty's condition had stabilized. I got home to find that Hawk had called from a payphone. He wanted to meet. We weren't going to sit down to tea, though. Hawk was on the run and wanted the place where we met to have elbow room.
Nelson signed an affidavit swearing he saw you at the scene. Warrants being drawn up, attempted murder.
You sure tapped in?
Rita called.
Oh, yeah? To tell you she's doing her job. Or is it her job calling you?
Paranoia doesn't become you.
The goal is staying alive, then paranoia seems a reasonable strategy.
I told her it was a frame-up, that you wouldn't shoot Marty Quirk.
What about my cellmate's latest motive?
Flaherty? Shooting a cop's not his style.
Man's got no style. What he's got is a grudge coming my way. Owes me money. Know that I can spin a tail or two.
Seems like it'd be easier for him just to pay you the money.
Or set me up.
Want to hear my theory?
Talk to me quick.
New talent in town.
Wild card.
Somebody crazy enough to shoot a cop in the back. I'm gonna start looking.
Slow your roll. He's mine. I'll find the loose marble, and I don't want to trip over anybody on the way. Ergo, you tell Belson Sergeant to stay off me. Those paranoids get real jumpy.
I'll tell him.
I talk, you listen. I got some pressing business in the street. Sick of your shadow on my neck. Drop it, or I'll leave your brains in some Boston gutter.
Yeah. Shot in the back like you done Marty.
Spenser warned you once, Sergeant Frankie, but you're not getting it. Either you find some hard evidence that I laid a hammer on Quirk, or get off the phone.
I saw you.
You saw a tall, brown man in the dark of the night.
And the moon's made out of green cheese.
I hear you, Sergeant Frankie. Your boy Quirk went down and you feel you have a score to settle. Well, that horse of justice you riding running dead last.
No, I'm way out in front of you, Hawk. Flaherty's whole operation is coming apart at the seams, and it's only a matter of time before he's got to finger you to save himself.
Last time, my opic man, I don't pop cops. You keep charging at me and we gonna be all up in a nursery rhyme.
I'll take my chances.
Take him in court where you got a shot. You make another move at me and the shot'll be mine. And this time, I'll take it.
How's your fun level?
About a quart low. What you got?
Word's out. Contracts to find and dispose of you.
They're welcome to try.
Why don't you take a little trip? See if I can get a handle on this thing.
I'm duty bound. Gotta find out who killed Loverboy. Somebody gets off that I'm responsible for, they got to waltz with me.
Well, try this. Belson ran the gun, 22 caliber, registered to Brian Lord.
Must be suicide.
I shoots himself three times from across the room.
I shall find the trigger finger. What about your wandering bookkeeper?
Nothing yet.
Looky here. You got a client about to be convicted of murder. I got a client that's dead. We might want to think about changing occupations. Ha ha.
Close!
It's almost as good as the one you made for Carlos.
This has a longer range. Reloads faster.
Kills neither.
A weapon is a product of craftsmanship. It is man who kills his brother.
Right. You working late, Sam?
The craft I practice takes time.
You remember who you crafted this for?
My father taught me everything I know. He believed precision was artistry, the gun his masterpiece. That a person who's willing to pay handsomely for that artistry also purchased the right to anonymity.
Anonymity, and precision, right? You are a very precise man. Spotless. Everything buttoned up, screwed down. It's not like you to leave a thing half done, is it? Or half open.
Of emergency dial 911.
What took you so long?
Didn't want to spoil your fun unless I had to.
Were you telling him?
Waited.
How'd you know to wait here?
Connections.
What else do you know?
Your client's real name isn't York. She got that from the agency when she escaped from East Germany.
You know who the Hitler youth program here was working for?
You said one soup, not two.
That's it then?
Keeping you alive ain't enough?
It'll do.
You were doing real well till he slammed that phone upside your head. But I guess you're right. We all slow down with age. Nice piece. I'll let you call Quirk about this. You're so familiar with that phone.
I got two problems.
You got it down to two?
That's two you can help me with.
About 212 nobody can help you with.
Yeah, but who's counting? I need to stash this guy with you for a while.
Who's after him, cops or robbers?
Gus Harley.
Damn, no wonder you come to me.
And I need to set up a meeting with Gus.
Meeting to do what?
Try to keep him from acing this guy. You got any connections with Gus?
Maybe.
So, what do you think?
I can get you together. Dig this here. Gus be a funny guy, very sentimental, very tough.
Much like myself.
Bad temper, no scruples.
Much like yourself. Mm. Can you do it?
Got a safe place.
Where?
Wouldn't be safe if I told you where it was, now would it? No. Look at the ducks.
These people, you listen to Hawk? Since when do we start listening to people like Hawk?
You sure you didn't find him on the front steps, Gus?
What the hell is that supposed to mean?
Georgie.
Huh?
Means you about much like your father as a beetle's like a dragon.
Yeah, you wash your mouth, Hawk!
Means you ain't got no style, Georgie. Means your word ain't worth nothing.
Anytime you want to, G-man. Any way you want it. You feeling froggish now? Leap!
Not a good day to die, Jimmy. Put your hands on the wheel.
Your reputation precedes you, Mr. Hawk. So good of you to call.
I'm a man of few words. You better get it all on the first take.
Yes, well, perhaps we can discuss business over lunch.
It's your appetite I'm here to talk about. I don't like it. And I don't tolerate jackals who feed on folk before they're dead.
Then you can well understand that I don't give a damn what you don't like. Get out of my car.
You don't understand. There's nothing here belongs to you, my African brother. This is my town. You got any doubt about that, you ask your Jimmy here. We talking about territorial imperative. This is my territory. It is imperative that you leave.
You should be delighted to know that I am returning to Africa this afternoon.
I lament for the continent. Don't miss that plane, my African brother. I will not ask you twice.